This is my slow-cooked beef brisket. It's the new hipster bolognese. It's got a beautiful piece of beef brisket. When you cut the brisket into four pieces, you've got more surface area exposed to all those beautiful flavours that we're going to be simmering it in. All this marbling melts away and you end up with the most tender piece of meat. Just a little bit of olive oil in my pan. Cut the brisket in. You want to have it really well browned and caramelised on the outside. That's where all the flavour's going to come from. I just need three cloves of garlic. Brisket, unlike mince, is going to have the most amazing texture when we finish with it. All of these beautiful threads of meat are just going to fall apart and melt in your mouth. That beef is looking gorgeous and caramelised. Just a little bit more oil. And then in with our onion and our garlic. Okay, they're getting nice and soft. I love all that brown in the base of the pot. That's just going to add extra flavour to our brisket. Next thing I'm going to add is a cup of red wine. I like to add it at this stage because I like to burn off the stronger flavours of the alcohol. I want the fruity flavours of the wine, not the sharp ones. So just let that reduce down. Oh, that smells great already. Now, the way that I know that this wine has reduced enough is that it gets a really lovely sheen to it. Next thing I'm going to add is 2 cups of beef stock, 2 cups of water, 3 cups of tomato puree, and then something that my mum always used to do and that I do is just have to add a little bit of water to this, give it a shake. I can hear her saying now, waste not, want not. And then just 6 bay leaves. Right, all of those flavours are in, so we can return our beautiful brisket pieces to the pan. I mean, these are just all of the classic bolognese flavours, only with a different, more textured cut of meat that just loves to be slow-cooked. Then it's simply just on with the lid, and then it's into the oven where all the magic happens. That's our 3 hours. Let's take a look. Oh, yes. Amazing. Smells so good. Little chunks of brisket are just falling apart. All I need to do to finish this is to fish out the bay leaves and then just shred the meat. It doesn't take much for that meat to just fall apart. What a great basic recipe to have in your repertoire. You can make so much with this. Now that I've made this perfect beef brisket, let me show you how easy it is to use as a base for more deliciously comforting dishes. Beautiful classic lasagna made even better with a couple of cheats and my beautiful slow-simmered brisket. I like to lighten this up by making just a fresh ricotta layer to replace that kind of gluey bechamel. Just lots of creamy fresh ricotta, generous amount of grated fresh mozzarella, and for a little bit of bite, grated parmesan. To make it even more creamy, I'm just going to add a big splash of milk. Let's face it, if you're going to eat lasagna, why not have layers of creamy, cheesy goodness to go with our melt in the mouth, slow simmered beef brisket. So into the base with a sheet of fresh pasta, then this beautiful slow simmered beef. It smells so good. Another layer. I don't think you can build a lasagna with too many layers. Pile up that ricotta. Just leave one cheeky corner of the lasagna sheet uncovered because that'll be the crispy bit that I steal. Let's just finish it with a light sprinkling of grated parmesan. And that's ready for the oven. Golden, bubbling, simple beef and ricotta lasagna. Just going to finish it with some fresh basil, little drizzle of olive oil, and of course, one final grate to bring that all together. Can never have too much Parmesan cheese. And that really is a simple beef and ricotta lasagna. Mmm. My take on an Australian classic, brisket pot pies. Just take our beautiful soft simmered beef brisket, load up some pie dishes. Make sure you grab lots of that juicy sauce from the base. A little bit more, generosity being the key. Just got some store-bought pre-rolled puff pastry. If you can't find a cutter big enough, try using one of your bowls or a little side plate. So we get the maximum rise and puff, use a sharp knife and make decisive cuts. If you drag your knife, you'll crush the layers and you won't get that lovely flaky lift that we're looking for in our pie. So the steam can escape from the pies, I like to just make a little cross in the middle of each one before I pop them on. Really is easy as pie. Finish with a little bit of beaten egg, just so that pastry is golden brown on top. A little bit of sea salt to finish, quick sprinkle on top, and they are in the oven until they are golden brown and that pastry is lovely and puffed. Now, my take on an Australian classic, brisket pot pies. This is one recipe I can't live without. If I don't have a jar of my Asian chili jam in the back of the fridge, things just don't seem right. It's a bit front heavy, this recipe, all the work up front, and then you've got something magical in your fridge on standby that you can serve with just about anything. I'm using the long chilies because they have all the flavor, but without all the heat. Just give it a rough chop. My food processor is going to do most of the work for me. I've got a little eschalot, 3 cloves of garlic, then I've got some really beautiful young ginger. When you get it this young, all you have to do is just rub off some of the papery edges, give it a little trim, but there's no need to peel it, which is fantastic. This chili jam goes with just about anything, from chicken to any type of seafood, even just stir fry up some veggies. That's what I like to do when I'm pushed for time. Just some nice fresh greens stir fried in this chili jam and I am in heaven. And then that just goes all into our processor. Voila. Done, all finely chopped. Non-stick fry pan on the heat, a couple of tablespoons of vegetable or nut oil, and then just 2 teaspoons of sesame oil. This is quite strong, so don't overdo it. It's a great flavor, but a little goes a long way. Into the pan. Now at this point, you need to stir this mixture continually. Quite pungent when you're cooking this paste. Good for the sinuses. Keep it on the go because you don't want it to catch on the bottom of the pan. You just want a nice, even caramelized golden paste. All is well in my world if I have a jar of this lurking at the back of the fridge at all times. It's my flavor savior. Just a few more ingredients to bring our paste together and to finish it. 1/4 cup of rice wine vinegar. Just 2 tablespoons of fish sauce. And then 2/3 cup of brown sugar. Just bring that to the boil. You can tell when the paste is done because it looks like bubbling praline toffee. What we have is gorgeous, really well-flavoured chili jam. All you need to do is let that cool and we can spoon it into some jars and hide it in the back of our fridge for that time when you need a little hit of flavour. Now I'll share with you my secret so you can use it to create something really impressive with just the right amount of kick. beautiful day today. It would be shame not to cook outside. And what better recipe to throw in our barbecue than my chili jam crab? Look at that colour. They are amazing. They are the sweetest, most delightful crab meat. Sometimes they just need a little bit of extra convincing. And believe you me, the effort is worth it. Whew. That's the hardest part about this recipe, and it's all done. Couple of tablespoons of peanut oil, and in they go. Let's give them a quick toss about. And before the crabs are fully cooked, I'm going to add my chili jam. Let's be generous. Some big spoonfuls. Yum. Just turn the crabs about in the wok, making sure they're beautifully coated in all that caramelized chili jam. So it's just time to garnish them and then bring some people over to the wok. Just a squeeze of lemon. Just to finish that nice citrusy edge. A couple of wedges, just a sprinkling of prettiness to finish it off. Gorgeous. So easy and great to serve right from the barbecue. Why not cook up some chili jam prawns on the barbecue? All I've done is taken the shell off the body of the prawns and slid them onto a skewer. Great for entertaining or a little snack. Grab some chili jam and just paint those gorgeous prawns. In my opinion, you can't have too much of this chili jam, so let's be super generous. They don't take too long to cook. Yum, that smells good already. Just a little bit more. Why not? A really clever garnish to serve with our prawns, some char-grilled lime halves. When you pop the lime halves on the barbecue, they char-grill and become caramelized and golden and a little bit sweeter. So when you squeeze them over the prawns, they just add that amazing edge. Prawns don't take very long. As soon as they change colour, become nice and opaque, and the chili jam's caramelised around the outside, they're ready to serve. Those limes are nice and char-grilled. Let's squeeze one over the top, just to start them off before we serve. And that is a perfect summer dish.